Hey, what's up guys, I'm Praetorian and welcome back to Millennia. So in today's episode, we'll be moving through the Age of Alchemy and hopefully exploring the world as we'll be getting our first ships. So here in the beginning of the episode, we need to move this army. We're not being notified that they're here because there's nothing they can do other than go into the sea. They can't move anywhere. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and spawn our first utility ship. And then I guess we'll wait to move them over here because I don't want them to get stuck in this army here. Just forget that they're there. So we'll leave them here. So the next turn I'll show you what those do. And then we're also going to spawn ourselves a pioneer here in Gaul. And begin moving them over to here. So let's go ahead and tell these guys to just chill out. And then I believe we can go to end our turn. I don't think there's anything else we need to do here. So let's go ahead and move on to the next turn. We're two turns away from getting our technology. And this turn, we should be able to get the next of our government bonuses here, which is the round table. And that'll give us that diplomacy bonus from the vassals. And so that'll be incredibly helpful. So we just look at, you know, one of our key vassal cities here, Osaka. And you see we're now earning 2.33. We're also earning that 2.23 for the government. And you can see just how beneficial this is going to be for us now that we have that. So now we're earning 34 diplomacy XP per turn. So very helpful. All right, so let's get this guy moving into the forest over here. And then we want to put these guys back on the land. And then we'll move our utility ship over to the fish. So utility ships are effectively the same thing as the bow hunters, except where you use them here on the sea. So this is a way to get access to the good without using your population. And so that'll go to the nearest city here. So Naples is now getting access to tuna, which is a +5 food. And so we could send these utility ships to all of these locations, and then we're just sending tons of fish back to Naples. Obviously far more than they actually need. So utility ships are very powerful, just like the bow hunter, but maybe a little bit more powerful simply because of the fact that there's so many fish locations around the map, much more than what you'll find when it comes to the locations that your bow hunters can actually work. Now in the default ages, I don't think there's any other sea goods that you could even use your utility ship for. There's only the fish. However, there are some other sea goods available in one of the alternate ages. The Age of Utopia, you'll get underwater cities, which I always name Rapture. You can name the first one Rapture, and then the second one like Atlantis or something like that. Because I'm super original like that. But yeah, they have underwater cities, and so they have to put all these different goods out in the sea so that the underwater cities have a reason to exist. I guess we'll go over here and try and remember to move them back out of there. But yeah, there's a bunch of goods out there in the sea in that particular age, and I don't know if the utility ships can be used to get those. So this one's going over to here. I haven't actually tried to use them for that. It would be super useful if you could, because you could use them to get like oil. It doesn't make a whole lot of sense though, because these are kind of, I mean, they look like fishing chips or something, right? You know, that's what they're supposed to be, right? Going out there and fishing, bringing those back to Naples. So I don't know how much sense it makes. I mean, it doesn't say that they had to be used for fish though. Just says resource collection. There's one unique resource in that age that'd be incredibly useful to be able to use that for. Surprised I didn't even try, because it gives you a +1 for every type of experience. So yeah, we don't have any buildings to get here, we're just gonna get more bow hunters, and somebody told me that you can get up to 2, that's it, if you do shift click. I didn't even try that, I tried control and it didn't work. I don't know why I didn't try shift. So yeah, you can get up to 2 here, so that's helpful. So you set the next 2 things you want to build, but can't do any more beyond that, unfortunately. But that's still helpful, it's better than only being able to do 1. We did get the Grand Theater here in Ravenna. Might want to go and get the museum, because we're going to be unlocking some buildings that require education soon. So getting that would be helpful. But I also want to start constructing some units here. You know what, let's go and get the barracks, because only one city currently has that. So there's actually one thing I did forget to get last turn. I wanted a prospector over here. Might even get 2 of these guys. We're going to make these gold hills. And could even get another one here since we're about to access something where having that gold would be helpful. So yeah, let's get a couple of these. Can they do their action? They can. All right, so we're gonna do one here. Let's put gold all throughout these hills here. Of course, we need to construct the mines. And then we're also gonna get one over here somewhere. I don't think there's any more. Well, there is one more hill location here. Yeah, it's fine if we put it over here, like right there. So we'll have to do that next turn. But we can go ahead and get access to at least one of these. So we'll do that. Because they have a lot of population here in Ravenna. I think Ravenna has the highest population at the moment that's not doing anything. So we can see that they do need additional food. And we already have the flour being produced here. So I think it's about time to go ahead and get some bread. So this will be the first oven I believe we created. This will turn to 2 flour to bread. That's 10 plus food for each of those. So very useful, but still not quite enough because they have such a high need here in order to get to the 200%. We're almost there. You only need 4 more food. But I think we're going to go ahead and get some foresters over here to increase their production. So I'm going to get those knocked out. And that's all we have as far as our points go. So let me see if we want to spend any of this money, because if it's really cheap, like in the case of this 20 gold here, then we'll go ahead and get it. So that's the market square. And so we'll want to go ahead and add these foreign import slots in Gaul. They really have a shortage of space in Gaul. So we're trying to take care of that. And I think production is not going to be their issue. Because you'll see here what we're going to do with their next town. We do need more improvement points. So we're going to go ahead and get some bricks here. And you know, let's get some for the experience. And I think some art experience with the talismans would be helpful. So let's go ahead and get that. There we go. So then I'll step up our art experience just a little bit. So we can use it for immigration, though I don't think we have anywhere to use it now because Constantinople is all the way up to 10. So that's not an option, but we can do the spawn artist as well as the promote cultural exports. We'll certainly have this in time so that as soon as we finish with this culture, we can go and get an artist and get another culture. All right, so Gaul has that constructed. Let's go ahead and get, just take a look at their unrest. They could use a watch. Yeah, we're going to get the watch since that is now at this point cheaper than the guard reserves. Just make sure they don't have any unrest issues in the future because this is already upgraded. So you can't do that if you do find yourselves in a bit of a problem there. So Rome does need to send this bow hunter. Send him over here. And then we'll get the 2 more for the elephants here. And then I think that's it. I don't think we have any other locations where we'll need bow hunters. So we'll probably start with the construction of military units. Although there'll be probably some buildings for us to work on at that point. All right, so let's go ahead and end our turn. And we'll get that tech done and we can finally make use of our new resource here. Which there's just so much of it. Very plentiful. Unfortunately, their borders have expanded. So we might be competing with them for this tile here if we don't get there soon. Wow, that's kind of far out. They might have to purchase it. Another thing we could do, if we really want to step up our diplomacy XP that we're currently gaining, is go ahead and get these in the desert. Or at least get one of them. Because yeah, we don't have any more locations over here to build them. You cannot build them, you know, inside the cities. So I mean, if you just look at all these, because you wouldn't find it in here either. That's not an option. You can only do it in the outposts. And so therefore, we'd want to build one here. I guess we'd do that one. And then one over there. Just to try and get more of that diplomacy XP. So we can get through here quicker. Particularly with the colonialism, we want to get to the 75% max prosperity. That'd be incredibly helpful. All right, so let's go and find some gold over there. And keep that guy moving along. And we're going to be setting up right... either right here or right here. Either one would work. That'd be close enough to get the road here. I think going further south might be more beneficial so that you have your borders going that way and this way. put it right here. It's only one tile. Doesn't that make a huge difference? But as you see, there's only so much to get over here. Let's see, there's a location right here. Our bow hunters just combined two, so that's going to cause some confusion for them. And of course, I forgot about this character. I knew it would. So it's going to get it moving over to here. And then we've got one more down here in the south. And these guys can also upgrade, so let's go ahead and do that. Upgrade them to a musket. And then we're just going to move them back to where they're at, which is kind of just defending Rome from any threats. Bowhunter got over here, so we can put him back to work. And we did finish up our technology over here. Excellent. So that's going to allow us to get an additional town for all of our cities. So you can already see that town slot there. And we also got the perfume shop. I don't know if we'll build those. It's wealth and luxury is helpful. If we got nothing else to construct, like in Rome, then maybe you'll get it. But I think there's other things that are far more important since wealth is so plentiful in this game. But the panaceas, on the other hand, this looks like a fantastic improvement. It does cost 76 arcana, but that's very plentiful. And now you're going to get 16 food and 16 sanitation for only 2 gold. I mean, that just seems so useful. So for the next thing that we're going to get, we're actually going to go back and get these the machine tech. Let's get you the workshop building, which we need that in order to construct those early tanks. So it's 2 turns, we're just going to get it. We know we're well ahead in technology at the moment. It's not really an issue. And then these guys are going over to here. So a whole bunch of bow hunters heading south now. And this might be the last one we need. Yeah, because we have 3 already coming down here. And there's only 4 locations. So yeah, the one we're currently constructing is all we will need there. So Ravenna, that'll be 570. I'd prefer to save up to rush this out. We can actually rush it out now. So might go ahead and do that. Let's do the culture first though. It's not gonna cost much, it's only 15. We can't do over here yet. So we're probably gonna wanna wait. Okay, so I guess what we'll do is do this one for Rome. And we'll wait to do that, because we're going to use the Absorb Outpost over there, guys. I think that'd be the best option, since it allows us to not worry about having to buy so many tiles. It's one less tile that we'd have to purchase. So that would be helpful. But over here, we already know what we're doing. We're going to create our town in this location. Great for farming. Couldn't get much better than this, other than this location here. You can't build a farm there. But now we'll want to get rid of this here. So before we do it, and I know we're going to lose the benefits that we're getting from these tiles here, but that's fine. We're going to make sure that we get back our investment, at least some of it. And then we're going to go ahead and take this and revert it back to a pioneer. I don't think we have any other ones in here. No. Now that does result in us losing the bonus that you get from having the castle. It just doesn't show here, but it's +1 warfare experience and +1 culture. And so that is overall better than what we're getting from the outpost, which is just +5 wealth. The outpost does seem to have a pretty good defensive unit situation here with the 3 caravan guards. Might be better than the 3 units that you get with the castles. I was looking at their stats and they certainly seem a lot better. So surprisingly, the outpost in our particular case might be better for defense than the castle. And it's also better for the wealth and the border vision. But the castle gets you the culture and the warfare experience, so I don't know. It still seems like it's better overall. So if you've already constructed all these things here, then you could switch it over to a castle. It's not like you lose access to any of those. So you could do that. It does cost that engineering experience, but it'd be an option. So we need to get this guy moving over to just somewhere we can work 2 resources. And that isn't going to block the growth of any of our borders. Yeah, that wouldn't be a good location there. There might not be very many good locations. We could also have this guy. Well, there's one right here. Yeah, why not do that? Because remember, the trading posts are free. Oh, well, no, that blocks this. Same thing here. Because eventually those will all be within our borders. And so it might be better to go ahead and start setting up for our exploration. Just looking for something here. I'm not seeing anything, guys, where it's not going to block it. Block our growth, I mean. So you know what? Let's go ahead and get this guy moving over to here, where our ships are going to be. And they can hop in a ship and maybe also bring our explorers. That would be wise as well. Start bringing them up there, because we do have these two explorer armies not doing anything. And we want them to be escorted across the sea. So let's go ahead and bring both of these up north. So, all going to Naples. Alright, so now we need to spend this Arcana here to get that new improvement that we have. So these are down here, the Panacea. And so I'd like to get one of these in Rome to better make use of the population. Because you could get, I mean, they don't need food at the moment. But this one I think we're going to do is get rid of one of the trash heaps. So you could leave, I don't know, you leave that one over there and that one there and just get rid of this one. I know that it might be useful in the future, but I'm also trying to clear space out. And we'll probably just put this here. And you'll see what else we're going to do here in a minute. So we're going to get that constructed. So that's going to turn the 2 gold. So we already have 2 gold here. So we're going to put that here. And so that will fix any, you know, sanitation needs they have. They should be good for a long time, actually. You can probably get rid of another one of these, or at least stop working it. We could tell them to stop working both of them. So we'll probably take those out and use them elsewhere. And we're also going to get rid of this farm here. That's really not Rome's thing. They're not building the farming chain, using the wheat and then turning it into the flour and turning it into bread. They're just not doing that. They have tons of meat, like absolute ton of meat here, guys. And there's so many other ways. That's that Panacea, by the way. There's a ton of other ways to get food. This is just one of them here. That's a lot of food. So I just don't think we need this anymore. And there's just better things we could do with this particular location. And with that population as well. So for example, we should probably get this gold taken care of over here. Let's build the deep mine there. That's all of our improvement points at the moment, but we do have more Arcana that we can spend, and we know we have gold here in Ravenna. So let's go ahead and make use of that to get the Panacea. And we could even maybe get rid of one of those, or at least stop working them. So place that there, and then yeah, let's just go ahead and I think I haven't set where they're forced to, well, maybe not forced to work it. But yeah, that population would be used elsewhere. Once we have like the improvement points and stuff. And so yeah, it just will really help us satisfy our needs when it comes to the food and the sanitation. Alright, so we're going to go ahead and rush out the ship for 1240. And I guess we'll get another ship constructing. Yeah, we'll go ahead and make sure we're focusing on these ships here. It's kind of expensive rushing it out, but we do earn a lot of money now. So what we're looking for is islands. Good solid islands to settle on. Set up outposts on. As well as for the other continent, which is going to be across the ocean either this way. I mean, you can go either way because it is a globe. So you can go this way or you can go that way and eventually you'll hit the continent. I don't know if there's anything else we need to do there. Yeah, I really want to make sure we get control of that. I don't know if I'm willing to invest the points in it, though. Yeah, just go out here, explore, and see what we can find. Of course, as of right now, we haven't found anything. Rome has finished up the construction of those bow hunters, so we don't need any additional ones. So we haven't gotten any dragoons yet, but at this point, I don't know if it's worth doing. Because the muskets are just better in almost every way. So you can see that their attack and defense are higher. The morale is higher. So the only real benefit of the dragoons is the lower production costs and the increased movement speed. Because everything else is the same. Upkeep, unrest suppression, their 2-time attack modifier against the cav units. You're just getting better attack and defense and better morale. So it makes more sense to make use of those. Catapults, I mean, they're really outdated at this point. So really just want to get muskets because everything else is kind of outdated until we get some additional techs. So yeah, we'll just build a couple of these. I know we have some armies that aren't up to their full strength yet. So Ravenna has finished up the barracks, our essence, so they could start constructing units if we need to. But let's get a few other things. We'll go ahead and do the museum Could also get the market square to increase their foreign import slots. Let's go ahead and do that, actually. And I don't think there's anything else we want to purchase here. Again, just save money to rush out the ships. We really need to start investing in that. So with the colonialism, we don't want to get that. I'm going to wait until we get the 150 here. So let's go and get all of our units moved. Many of them are heading up here. We won't move an army across. I think it's better to use the explorers for that. Keep our armies back home. Even if we're not really using them at the moment. You know what? We don't want them to combine with that. So we'll have to move them over here. And the combination causes issues when they combine together. Alright, so yeah, I think we're going to have this outpost set up over here. And we do need to spend our engineering experience. I'm getting distracted here. We'll do this first. We need to spend our engineering experience here. Go ahead and level it up now while I'm thinking about it. So get that up to level 3. And then we're going to be turning into the first farming town. We don't have any farms here just yet. We won't construct these because we don't need food. But we will get these two bonuses from the plantations as soon as this is in our territory. I was going to get the artists, but just going to wait for that now. And these guys are moving up north as well. Could have our heroes go up there, since we don't know what to do with them. We're trying to get them some experience. There's a lot of barbarians to fight out there. You know, let's go ahead and do that. In fact, sending any heroes that aren't fully leveled up, because eventually we're going to go ahead and retire all these heroes that we got. So yeah, going across all of our armies, retiring these, and instead promoting these guys to leader 6 would be the better way to go. So let's go ahead and find all of our armies. We got an army somewhere down here. We have the one in Kyoto, because we never did get the town guard here. So we need to do something about that. So let's go ahead and get this hero moving up, as they don't have their full experience yet. So we're just going to send the heroes all out into the sea to do some fighting. Yeah, Kyoto, as soon as they finish this, it's taking them a while. It'll be 701 to rush it out. So as soon as they finish that, we'll make sure we get a town guard unit or whatever. But there is another army down here. And so they have a hero. Their hero is fully leveled up. Let's go and retire this hero. Get the army experience and then use that to level up this guy. It costs us 84, so we're not quite there. Because what I'm thinking about doing is attacking Persia. Because why not? We are pretty much just trading with the Aztecs now. And we're going to have a whole bunch of other trade partners that we can trade with. I know that we didn't go with the commanders because we weren't really focused on warfare, but we don't really need it either. I feel like we have a huge tech lead on them. If we just take a look at the other countries here, they're both in the Age of Renaissance currently. We have a huge tech lead. And so we already have a big old advantage over them. So we don't really need a national spirit to give us an additional advantage. Despite the fact that we are swimming in the Arcana, or, you know, we're getting a lot of it, these upgrades are pretty expensive. So you do actually need a considerable amount of it. Alright, so now we need to spend our improvement points, as well as, I mean, I don't know if we have, we do have gold here, spare gold. Let's go and get the deep mine there. You know, they don't really need another panacea currently, because they've got plenty of sanitation. Yeah, sanitation's doing great. You know, we don't even have to work this location. They have plenty of food as well. So we don't really need to construct anything else there. As the locations don't have any gold yet, that's where we probably want to do this. And so like right here, I mean, they don't have food issues either, but eventually they're going to need, yeah, they're going to have some trouble with sanitation. Kyoto, unfortunately, does not have any hills. And so we will not be able to use any of these bonuses without, I mean, I guess what you could do is you could use your slots here to get gold. So that would be an option. If there is, yeah, there's two here. And so, yeah, we could get the 2 gold in order to fix their problems that way by constructing the panacea. But let's first use our own supply of gold that we should be able to get access to by constructing more of these prospectors. So I put gold in these hills over here. These would be the gold hills. Everybody has rushed to this location to get access to the gold. Alright, so yeah, we'll now be able to get that panacea, seeing where I want to construct it. I'll put it right here. Although, I don't know where it's at in there, so we'll just do it through here. Alright, excellent. So, they will not have any issues with food or sanitation for quite some time, because that is just so helpful. Very, very powerful, guys. I think that's it. We have no improvement points left, or Arcana, for that matter. Alright, so let's go ahead and end our turn. We're going to be getting this tech done. And we're going to want to construct that in Rome as soon as they're done with their units that they're making. Osaka's got some gold over here. I don't know if they can build stuff that requires Arcana. Because they don't produce that. I'm not sure how that works. Probably not. Yeah, I would assume they wouldn't be able to do that. So we're just going to start moving down now. I'm looking for islands that might be in the middle here. That'd be an initial place to set up some outposts. It gives us a location we can spawn different types of units and stuff that we might want out there. Alright, so this guy is going to... Well, let's first get them moving down, because they're all messed up. Yeah, everybody's all messed up over here. And he can now set up the outposts. Right, excellent. So now we just have to buy one tile for Gaul. So we can buy this one, or the forest right there. I like the idea of buying this one so you start moving towards the Gaul, because the Gaul are just so useful now. And they have access to these hills. So I think that would be the one that we would purchase. We need to save up 108 for that. And then with our culture here, we would then absorb the outpost. And that gives you control of all this area, so that's one additional benefit of using the absorb outpost. So you get that, in addition to the fact that you're basically putting your town one step further than you normally would be able to. So if we bought this, then we could only put the town right here in one of these two. But this lets us put our town one tile away. And so that's kind of the benefit of doing the absorb town, I suppose. You do usually lose all of the things you constructed, since most of those are unique to outposts. You also lose the pioneer. But overall, it does have some bonuses. So we're just looking for more Arcana. Let's get this unit moving up to our port in Naples. And we don't have to launch from there. You could always have them sitting around here and then have the ship come to escort them. But since we don't have the ship done yet, might as well send these units north. All these heroes. I don't even think we grabbed everybody, did we? I was looking at them all, but then we didn't finish it. So we can go ahead and retire this character. And then we want to promote these units here. We're just waiting to get enough experience, which we do have at this point. So because this is a leader 6, you have the 6 tactics, plus we have the 3 from the veterancy. So those heroes, remember, they were getting us 8. So 8 tactics, while this one has 9. So it's only slightly better, but once you get the next veterancy level, since we did lose one, then that'll get you up to 10. So that's the highest tactics that the leader 6 can get you. Alright, so I don't think we need to do anything else with them now. Yeah, we're good to go. We do need to get all these upgraded, but of course we don't have the tech for that yet. Because they're just not as good as they were anymore. But yeah, we'll try and get those leveled up so we can get the maximum amount of warfare experience. And we're going to need units out there. Trust me, there's going to be a stupid amount of barbarians. Ton of barbarians. And we did finish up our technology. Alright, so that gave us the workshop and the logging camp. The logging camp doesn't give you more logs, it just gives you production, like extra production for working it. So it's helpful. So I think we're going to get the physics tech here. I would normally go after society, so we get the public library, because it's great for the 2+ knowledge at the expense of only one education. But since we're in the Age of Alchemy, we have a unique option here with the Alchemy School that also grants 2+ knowledge. In addition to that, it gives you one exploration XP. But you're also giving up an additional education, so it does have that penalty, that cost. But you get the same amount of knowledge and some exploration XP, so yeah, we're gonna go for that, guys. I suppose it also takes one more turn, so that's another thing to consider. But then the additional things you unlock, pretty good here. The alchemy lab, so you can turn the gold into analytics, turn it into knowledge. Just overall, this is going to be the best option for us for trying to improve our research speed so we can get some of these tasks knocked out a little bit faster. All right, so do we want to rush this out? Maybe 170. Really should be saving up for the ship. And we are actually going to have another chaos event eventually. So, I mean, we got a lot of turns until that happens, but probably don't want to, like, you know, always spend all the money that we have. We have improvement points. Could work on Rome, because their housing isn't quite where we want that to be. But just to show you guys what you get from this, it's the same amount of logs. You just get the 4+ production. That's the equivalent of getting 2 more logs, basically. So, I mean, it's still pretty good, but 16 improvement points. So, probably not the thing we're going to work on first. When we can get the deep mines to get another 4 production, that gives you actual iron, and then you could turn that into something else. And so if we really want to work on production, then we should probably get the last furnace here, and then upgrade the mines when we need it to get more of the iron. So that's what we're going to do, because I think we do have the iron. We had it available to get more ingots here, and then we can turn the ingots into something else. Of course, things will be changing soon with the steel production. I guess we're pretty much good here. I mean, we have a couple other population here in the poorhouse and the one in the trash heap that we could make use of. Do we have the ability to get any more books? No, we just have the one more paper, so that's not really an option. We do need the sanitation now, so we could always get another one of the panacea, because we do have the additional gold here. But I kind of want to get the knowledge there. And yeah, we have the trash heap here, so I'm a little surprised. We still are not at the 200% there. So yeah, they can always work that location. In fact, I'm going to go ahead and force them to do that over the whorehouse. We don't really need that wealth there. So Gaul currently has the lowest need efficiency. It seems like housing's causing the problem here. So we need to go ahead and get the poorhouse. So that's 35. So we'll get that in the next turn. Just kind of sort the cities and how we build there based on their need efficiency. Because some of them are getting a little bit lower. I mean, it's still good. It's still in the green. But yeah, we want to get these taken care of. Let's kind of move forward here, see what we can find. So far, I haven't found anything. No land out there. Okay, so we can see that the other continent's going to be right here. Okay. Seems like it's going to be small. I guess we'll have to see. You never know exactly how the continents will end up looking. There's not a lot of islands, unfortunately. These guys are all combined now. Great. I mean, there'll be a lot of, like, tiny islands. But you don't find large islands, unfortunately. It's a real bummer. I wish they had bigger islands. I've played on the continents map quite a bit, and the largest island I've ever found was 4 tiles. I've never seen anything that was larger than 4 tiles. So kind of a bummer that they don't have larger islands available. Maybe if you get really lucky or something. Yeah, I have not seen all that large of islands. So which city is this? This is Gaul here, so let's go and dip over to here. So we need to get that house in. So let's go and do that now. We're doing the poorhouse. And their unrest is now an issue. So I'm glad that we got the watch. I don't think there's anything else we can do here for that either. So we're clearly going to have to get another guard reserve. So that's what we'll work on now. Just so their unrest doesn't get out of control. And then, can we rush out this ship? We can. So we're going to go ahead and do that. And we still don't have any units over here yet, so let's go ahead and send this out exploring. And then we're going to construct another ship. I almost want to get the workshop to set their production up so that they can build these ships a little bit faster. Yeah. They do have the lower production. Maybe we should spend our improvements on production here. They don't have a ton of populations in around, but we do have some forester locations we can get here. Okay, so we're logging camps now. Still have these two here. And so we're going to want to get the logging camps all the way around here. Get that adjacency bonus for the reduction as high as possible. And then we can get everything built a little bit quicker. So I already see that the workshop is 3 turns now instead of 4. The Man of War would only be 4 as well. So yeah, we probably should have done that. It's really focused on this since this is the only location where we can construct ships. Constantinople could construct them here, but then they couldn't go anywhere. And I guess you got Gaul. They can construct ships as well, but their production's even worse. Yeah, so not the greatest location. They're further behind everybody else, so I don't think it makes a lot of sense to get the ships there. We haven't even got their second town here yet. So we can get the next colonialism here. So this one will increase the movement for the water transport. That'll be important as we move those units out there. This one's great because of the international trade, regardless of diplomatic status. So we don't have to send envoys across the sea in order to trade with them. The trade factory, I don't know how useful this will be, considering the fact that it's going to give you another good. But currently, we can get the trading post for free. So obviously, this is better, but you have to spend 57 improvement points on it. So would you rather, you know, spend 57 improvement points to get 2 goods, or spend nothing and get 1 good? So I'm not entirely sure how useful that will be for us, just because of the fact that we already have that other national spirit. So it kind of doesn't really gel that well, these two together. It'd be nice if this was free too. It should be free. But I guess that might be a little overpowered. So as far as which one we should get first, we don't have any colonies. Again, this one would be helpful, but I really think this one, so you can start sending settlers out there as well. That'll spawn 2 settlers for us. We also have another bow hunter over here. So we'll send that out. And then, yeah, these 2 settlers, which didn't cost any population. Which I don't know where they sent the other one. Probably right outside. There it is. We'll send them to be escorted by ships as well. And then we'll be able to, like, set up our first, like, colonies. So that'll be nice. And we also have a warrior over here. So we'll put that into this army. And we got 1 more that's currently being constructed. And let's just set them up to guard the city. Alright, so is there anything we need to purchase over here? So we're waiting to get 160 when it comes to feudal monarchy. Engineering, we want to save that. Not that there's much we can get anyways, but we want to save that to upgrade this town that we'll have soon. The arts, we're going to wait on that as well for the spawn artists. We'll do that after we get the culture. Wanted to assess if we need to be spending points on anything. Yeah, we need to get more of this gold as well. I suppose we could have done that. Just in the locations where we can. And most of our cities do have access to hills. It's just a few that don't. And so they'll be able to take advantage of that. And I'm going to move this one over here as well. Yeah, take advantage of those benefits from the gold. Alright, so we're right up along the ice here. So not surprising. We never did uncover any of this. We never went up here. We just saw it was mountains and didn't go up here. Okay, so I guess now we'll get to see what's here. We've already uncovered that there's coffee here. That'll eventually end up in Rome, but they gotta get over the mountains, and that takes a while. So we'll have to see what happens there. And this one, let's just go across. Because I'm assuming this is the additional continent here. So you see one of the landmarks that they discovered there. Let's go south. Another thing we can do with these ships, besides just looking for the islands in the middle, though I really do want to uncover those, is to try and see if there's anywhere up along the coastline where we can set up a colony. So that's what we'll do with that one, and probably the other ship too. They'll probably go up around the other way, so completely surround the continent, you know, wrap around it, I mean. So that'll be the plan with those. Let's go and get these goodies here, and there's another one over here. Just getting that Arcana. Because, yeah, I thought it was going to be something really, really plentiful, but they're so expensive that I find we don't have quite enough. All right, so these roads are keeping our units moving nice and fast here as they move up north. And are we done? We're almost done here. Close enough. Let's go ahead and move the merchant over here. And get this building up, which is already at 235% for the prosperity there. And that's just due to our 5% passive bonus that we have. There's one over here, so it's going to grab that. And there's another one not far away. So, I mean, when you're only getting 10 for each of these, yeah, you can see why you have to do it so many times. So let's go over to Rome real quick. We got the musket unit. Let me go ahead and move that before I forget. So this unit is going to move over to our army in the south. Good God, this is going to take forever for them to get over there. And I believe we have stuff to construct here. The workshop. Let's go and get that. In fact, I might change where that unit is moving. Have them come over here instead. Because remember, we're going to get those early tanks a little bit later than I would have liked getting them. But still, we'll get them. Try them out. We do have another slot here in Ravenna, so let's go and take advantage of it. Currently getting reduction and improvement points. Again, we don't really need food here. I feel like probably just production is really what they need. And of course, you could take these ingots and turn them into something more useful with our improvement points. Again, Ravenna does have that population, although it looks like we put them all to work. They did have a high population, but you know that was just sitting around, but that's not the case anymore. Okay, so we'll probably want to spend our improvement points elsewhere. Again, really focusing on the locations with the lower efficiencies, like Kyoto and Naples. So Naples, we do want to step up their production, as we were doing before. Let's go and get these logging camps. All right, so now we completely wrapped around this location, and so that's granting us 18 production from adjacency bonuses, as well as 18 wealth. So pretty good here, about as good as it gets, until you level it up to another, I don't think we can do that yet, to level 4. Yeah, we haven't got access to that yet. Yeah, eventually you can get it up to level 4 and we'll get even more production from it. Ravenna can construct something. We went in here and then we got them trading for something, but then didn't get anything constructing yet. So we just wanted some exploration XP. We could get the stone towers. We've seen there's a lot of stuff we could be getting with those. So that would be an option, but I feel like we should probably get the museum. As we're getting these other buildings unlocked, we're going to want that. More production is helpful. Well, they already have pretty solid production here. Let's go ahead and make use of this exploration XP to get another utility ship here in Naples. So they can start getting the fish over here. Now, these can be attacked and destroyed. So that's certainly something you gotta be aware of. Could get another prospector. Hopefully should have this soon once we get this new town constructed. I think it's a little expensive rushing that out right now. Especially when I want to use it for the ships. So we won't do that, but if anything's really cheap, like Constantinople here, 130, we'll get the market square. That gives them two slots. We're just going all in on the production and improvement points here. So the market square done. Could go ahead and get that workshop so we can get everything else constructed a little bit faster. Yeah, let's go and do that. Since Constantinople, they don't have the greatest production. It's sitting at just 24, so it's pretty low. Suppose we could rush out the waterworks here, finally. Took them a long time to get that constructed. They do not have a lot of production here, certainly not enough. But let's go and get the guard reserve now. Yeah, they definitely need to do something about their unrest. We can get the Parthenon eventually, too. But we'll start with the guard reserve. But yeah, we'll have to do a lot to get the unrest up because it's pretty bad there. Luckily, we have this whole army sitting here. That's really the only thing helping them. Well, these guys have not been updated at all. So we'll update one of those units. And just get them sent up to guard. So yeah, we're finally exploring the seas. Seeing what's out there. Have arrived at this additional continent. That is the Egyptians there. So yeah, we just met them. Let's go ahead and harvest the goods here for Naples. Increase their food. So yeah, we got some units moving south, some units moving north. while the ships explore the seas. Oh, wow. There was a landmark up here, guys. There's no way to get to it, though, because remember, we couldn't go out to sea. We would have had to get that tech to just briefly go into the sea and then come grab it real quick. So the Japanese ended up finding it. I mean, we went to the Age of Heroes, so it's fine. But that does mean that we can do this expedition now. So let me just see if we have any close. I guess they're all heading up here. So we'll send one explorer over there to do that. So I would figure there actually was one up here, but again, there's no way to get there until we could go to sea, you know, go out into the sea provinces. And we're just gonna have this guy go here for now because I don't want him combining there. So yeah, we would have gotten, had to get that tech. And I just never did that. Or not until much later anyways. Obviously we're out in the sea now. All right, so let's go to grab this location. Keep our explorers moving up north. And I suppose this is the, we'll take one of these guys and have him go over there. I'll try and remember to do that in the next turn. So yeah, lots of movement across our empire. She's grabbing up the Arcana here, and there's another one right next to it. So we got that next turn. So yeah, a lot of busy work with this. Again, I really wish there was a button to automate that. A little bit too much busy work for my taste. There is an island over here. We'll dip over there and explore that in the next turn. I don't know that we want to rush anything in Rome. Unless it's really, really cheap. It's already well ahead of everybody else on production. Now, we do have some improvement points. So let's go ahead and take care of, I think, well, you know, Naples is still the lowest at the moment. It's not food, it's actually sanitation that's causing the issue. So we need to get them some gold. There's no hills available where they haven't already constructed something, so can't do that. So you're gonna have to get a trash heap, basically. There's no way around it. So we're gonna get a trash heap right here. So look at that constructing, that sets them back up to 190%. All right, so let's go over to Gaul, guys, and get them a second town, finally. So we're gonna go ahead and claim this hill here, and then we'll make use of the Absorb Outpost. You know what? This could end up going to Ravenna, guys. We don't know who this will go to. Because Ravenna has an open, damn. Okay, so that's a problem. We have to give, because Ravenna has an open town slot. So basically, we have to construct Ravenna's next town. Which, I'm not entirely sure where we'd even put that. I wasn't planning on doing Ravenna just yet. Yeah, there's this area here, so I mean, if you wanted, you could put one there and you could have some production bonuses here. I feel like this needs to go to Gaul because they don't really have anything else. There's nothing down here anymore, so you can't construct that way. You can go this way, and this probably makes the most sense, is to go this way. But yeah, we can't purchase any territory, so you'd have to put it here. And then you're only getting the two bonuses there. Suppose we're going to have to do this in Kyoto, since we got to wait to do it in Gaul, which is unfortunate. But yeah, we'll just put it here, and it'll be like a farming town in the future, I suppose. So yeah, I was not wanting to build a town yet for them because I didn't really need it. But yeah, that's what we'll do. And you know what? Also, we know they have production issues here in Kyoto, so let's get them the logging camp. That'll help them out a lot. So yeah, kind of unfortunate. Because, yeah, we just don't know who that will go to, so we gotta wait. What we'll do is we'll spawn a pioneer, I suppose, and put him over here. Do the same thing we did over there. Closest location to that. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so clearly going this way would be the faster. So we'll put the pioneer there in the next turn. Is what it is. I wish they let you hect who you wanted to have absorb that. But I'm not entirely sure how it would work. And could ally with the Aztecs, but I kind of feel like they're going to end up getting conquered eventually. If we go attacking the Persians, then they'll have nowhere else to expand. So I assume that they would become enemies to us. It's just the way that it is. So we did get the workshop constructed. Let's go and get that armored vehicle now. We got two of these guys. Only takes one turn to get it done. Yeah, and I don't know how good those are going to be because they're all defensive. But Naples has also finished up their workshop. Well, the Oracle is only two turns, so we're going to get that. We could always use a bit more culture. It's definitely starting to, we're moving a lot slower. Part of that is because it just keeps getting more expensive every time I use it. The other part is that negative 31 from regions, so that's really hitting us hard. Alright, so yeah, we discovered that there. Did I ever send a unit over there? Let me do that now before I forget about it. So we'd have to go here and then go out to sea. It's not really the best way to do it, but because you could go around here, but I don't know, going through that forest probably would take longer. But yeah, now we know it's just north of Rome. Been here for thousands of years, never knew. Complete mystery. All right, so let's go and get these guys moving. This one's going over to this location. And then we'll get them all harvesting these goodies here. And so that's going to be great, because you're getting the expiration XP and the improvement points, in addition to more meat for Kyoto so they can grow faster, I suppose. I don't even know if they had any problems with meat, though. Food doesn't really seem to be their main issue there. Not seeing any other locations close here. We already have somebody down there. We should probably go over here then. Oh, there's one. Again, they're so hard to see. Maybe if you're like zoomed in really close, you can see it a lot easier. All right, so we're at 350% here. So let's go and get the merchant moving to, I bet they're done in Carthage too. They are. I don't know if we even have any more locations. I guess there's this one over here. It's pretty high as well. What we might want to do is send the merchants into a high population city among the Aztecs. I see 17 there, 20 over here, so that's clearly the best location. So we'll send one merchant down there. And the reason why we're going to do the Aztecs over the Persians is simply because, let me see which one, probably this one. Because we're probably going to attack the Persians. So it makes sense to do the Aztecs instead. They might be so powerful that even though they don't like us, they won't be able to attack us. Yeah, which I assume they won't like us once we conquer the Persians. They're going to be quite upset about that. So, how many more turns until we get the ship done? We're not constructing a ship yet. We're currently doing the Oracle. Okay, that's right. I forgot we're supposed to be doing ships here. My bad. Man of War, guys. I forgot we're in Naples there. We need ships. Of course. Alright, so let's go ahead. I'm sure some people were like, why are you not getting a ship there? So we can now see this island here. It's a three tile island. So not great. So these are the barbarian canoes. So just kind of show you what this looks like. Our first sea battle. It's ridiculous. And they're doing some damage to us though. They weren't even able to destroy them fully. So that's the battle with the barbarian canoes. As these guys still moving up north. And I suppose they can join with them. Now, we don't have, and we really need to get this, the increased maximum army size, so the ship can escort more stuff. So that's something to consider. Yeah, you're going to need some army units, you're going to need settlers, outpost people, you know, the pioneers. And so it would be helpful to have more slots for our fleet as well as our army. So let's spend our improvement points over here. We'll get the deep mine. Let's get that constructed and increase their production. And then let's go ahead and also get the ranch here so we can get the wool and the meat. And then maybe go ahead and get the fish with the fishing boats. So it gets us some more food. And then I suppose you need the plantations. And here I think we should do gold. And we have a gold here as well. I mean, they do need production. I guess you have another hill here. So it could do the gold there and then do something for production here. That'd be an option. Or, you know, do it the other way around, doesn't matter. But we don't actually have the improvement points right now. But yeah, I want to get some gold here, because I might want to get rid of this trash heap and instead get that one bonus. Didn't really need the food, though. And I guess they both grant 16 sanitation, and this can upgrade eventually and get you even more sanitation. Something to consider. I just like that it gets you the food and the sanitation. Which they do need additional sanitation, so I guess you can't really get rid of that, huh? Their problem here is lack of tiles. I might have to destroy some forest. A lot of times forests are pretty useful, but sometimes you gotta get rid of it. And so maybe to open up some slots for a goal, we need to use this engineering power to clear cut. It's kind of expensive at 50. But it doesn't get more expensive the more that you use it. And so there is that. Yeah, I really want to get that situation with this town sorted out. And so we need to get a town for Ravenna first. Egypt is already sending us a warning. Apparently our troops are too near their borders. Just whining at us. So yeah, we won't attack all these. It's just not necessary. We're out to explore. So we've got another island over here. Looks like another small one. And they're generally small. These guys are moving so slow because we don't have the road here anymore. Damn, I thought this would be close enough. Let me see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, damn. So we're one away. So that's unfortunate. We need to set up another outpost. Or Ravenna could get a town going up here, but I'm not entirely sure how you'd go about doing that easily. Yeah, I'll probably just do an outpost, guys. But we already have a pioneer spoken for, which is going to do the outpost over here. So we can't do that right now. All right, so we discovered this island. Let's go ahead and go back to the continent. Another island over here. Okay, so it's dipping in this way. I see. And then our merchant moving down south. That'll be our first merchant that we set up in a foreign city. Now that we have our prosperity up in the majority of our colonies at this point. So we want to set up two separate task force here. So probably one settler, one, maybe two pioneers, and then one hero and one explorer in each of these or something like that. I don't know. I think having a good number of pioneers in these armies would be helpful, since we get so many bonuses from the pioneers. So remember, what colonialism, we need to get to 180 here. That's the next thing we're going to get. Spice merchants don't really need that. Not what we want to spend our diplomacy power on. This one, we do want to get this now, but we want to wait until the innovation is in a better situation. Wait till we get the innovation event. I think that would be the better thing to do. So we'll just wait to get it. 2 class culture would be nice to have, but yeah, I think it's better to wait. And then these guys are going out to sea. And they'll start moving around here and get back on. Or they could just land here and then go over that way. Might be a little bit safer doing it that way. Keep your units at sea as little as possible, since those don't defend themselves well. So is there any other locations around here? I'm not seeing any. This might come over to this one next. Sure, why not? And then, didn't we just go over there? Just spawning, just moving back and forth. Suppose that works. We got a ton of money over here. Let's go ahead and rush this out. I know they're kind of expensive. We almost have our first kind of army or whatever ready. I want to get one more pioneer, but we are short on the engineering. Maybe we'll just put an explorer in that. Yeah, we'll just do that. This one can have 2 pioneers, it's fine. So I'm gonna put them out to sea, and that's our escort fleet. So instead of getting the fishing boats here, I probably should have made use of the utility ship. That would have been better to do that, but we can send them out over this way. So let me go ahead and get a harbor over here. So this will be our second harbor. So Gaul now has one. That gives us that exploration XP as well. And then we're going to get a utility ship. I meant to do this, and then just forgot about it. Alright, so you can go and move that now, I suppose. I mean, I guess Gaul's got plenty of population. So that's not really their issue. Naples, let's finish that Man of War. We're going to get another one. Nothing but ships, y'all. We need lots of ships. And don't want to rush that out. Yeah, I'm probably not going to rush any of these out right now. We do have a chaos event that could happen any moment. It's a 2.1% chance, so not high, but certainly could happen. All right, so where's the lowest efficiency? Still Gaul. Okay, so Gaul, we have issues here. They don't have any luxury, so that's part of the problem. What we could do is change what they're trading for here. I think our only option right now is tobacco, so we're gonna get that. That'll improve their efficiency up to 200%, so yeah, that gets you to 185. Still gotta take care of the sanitation. That's certainly an issue. And you can also get the plantations. They have a tobacco one. Shh, could have done that. It's fine, though, because they'll need, I mean, I guess they don't need it for a while. You could always change that back to whatever we had to get in the arts experience. I suppose we don't really need that. We need more bricks. We need the improvement points, guys. Currently getting 71, but it's still just not enough. You see that we're always needing more. We got that plantation that's more more food and more wealth. Not that they really need it, but 200% in Constantinople, 185 in Gaul. So now the lowest is Naples, once again. They do have access to this location here, so we'll want to get the quarry there. And then they have an additional location here where we could get a prospector once we have the exploration XP, which that just keeps on getting more expensive here. And so yeah, we'll put a prospector there and get access to that gold. All right, so this is going to be our last turn. We got a lot done. Things are slowing down, though. As you see, we're getting less turns in every episode because we just got so much going on. Lots of improvement points to spend, lots of units to move, more cities you got to manage. Yeah, we'll get that food for Gaul now. Again, they don't really need the food, but why not? Doesn't use population. Gaul has finished the construction of the guard reserve. So how are we doing on unrest now? Pretty solid. So we can go back to constructing buildings. Could of course get a ship as well, but it's kind of takes a little while here. 7 turns. Maybe get the workshop to improve that situation. Yeah, step up their production some. All right, so these guys are ready to go out. We haven't yet figured out where we want to settle first, you know, set up an outpost. Here you gotta destroy the barbarian camp and then you can set up an outpost there, but you're only getting access to the deer. That's it, there's nothing else here. So I don't know if that's a good location, probably not. Here you have the rice, but yeah, just not a good location either. So none of these are fantastic. And then this guy's going over here. And then he's going to right here, I believe is where we said we'd set him up. So we need 129 now to claim territory. So I actually shouldn't spend any more of these. Yeah, we'll stop spending it. We had so long where exploration XP was just so plentiful. I mean, we do earn a lot, 29 per turn. But yeah, I'm not used to needing to be a little bit more limited there. Alright, so we'll just move these guys over here. Just have them all chill out until they have an escort. Yeah, this is clearly not an island that we want to settle on either. Not a good location. I just feel like I gotta, like, cover all the dang clouds. I don't know if you guys will like that as well. Alright, so we don't want them to join up there because then we'll forget about them. Eventually, you get attack that will uncover everything for you, though it does basically break the game whenever on the turn that you get the tech. When it was like satellites or something like that, but it uncovers everything. But yeah, the turn that you get it, it seems like it broke because it gets stuck. You just need to leave it. Don't close it. You might get a little thing that pops up and says that it's not working. Do you want to close it? Don't do that. Just give it time. It'll eventually get there. But every time it happens, I feel like it's broken. And that's even if I've uncovered most of the map. Like, everything's already uncovered, and so there's not really doing that much. And yet it still breaks every damn time. So with the colonialism, we're getting that macroeconomics. So this will get us some merchants and 75% vassal prosperity. Right, excellent. Oh, yeah, I guess we can go ahead and get the legacy because we do have enough vassalized territories. So this will give us the diplomacy XP and also the tolerance. So again, tolerance isn't the most exciting of these. It's 8 more wealth per turn. We'll take it. All right, so we do have our tank unit. Or I guess it's not a tank. It's an armored vehicle. We're going to move this down here. And then we have our merchants, which we couldn't turn those into settlers. And I almost want to go ahead and do that. Yeah, I kind of feel like turning these into settlers would be useful. So let's go ahead and turn it into a settler. And have them join up over here. And then we could take this merchant and send them down south to get more wealth. Eventually, we're going to be swimming in diplomacy XP. And we could just get more merchants that way. While with the settlers, I mean, this does cost 15 government experience, by the way. We're waiting to do that until we get the innovation event, so it's just we're just kind of sitting on it anyways. So, I mean, it does have a cost. Yeah, I think it's worth it in this particular case, since we're going out into the world, set up some colonies. So we do have unrest stacking up here in Rome, so we need to take care of that by upgrading these units here. So let me just kind of dip through all our territory and make sure nowhere else is stacking up before we start getting chaos here. So yeah, this is not enough, so you'd have to upgrade one more. Ravenna's good. Yeah, everywhere else is good. It's just here in Rome where we're having issues. This is our high population, currently at 31. And you see we do have the education need. So remember, every population above 30 will require one education. Luckily, we already satisfied that need, but yeah, that's something to consider. And I'm going to tell them just chill for now. All right, so looking for more locations. We know there's one down here, and there's also one right there. So Rome does need more housing. So let's go and take, I don't know, do we want to get a villa? I mean, we really don't need the luxury. Probably should just get more poor houses, but the problem is the unrest. The unrest is an issue, so we might just get a house in this particular case. You get more housing than the villa. Obviously you're getting less wealth, and you're not getting the luxury, but yeah, let's just get a house, guys. So we'll get that constructed, get them back up to 200%. And I suppose we can now take advantage of these plantations here. Make sure we got the extra food, even though, you know, Rome does not need food. So we want plantations of both of these. Do we have enough? Looks like we have just barely. They did have free population, by the way. I did take a look at that. Though now I think they're pulling them out of the, yeah, they're pulling them out of there. Okay, so we could always change up where they're working. But yeah, I think it's fine for now. We did get this into our borders. Excellent. So I wanted to make sure that they did get access to the coal. There's a close one here. Naples is trying to get it as well. But that'll let us get this one too. And that'll be helpful once we've unlocked power. Alright, so is there anywhere we want to make use of this here that has both access to gold and requires sanitation or food? Probably not. Not anywhere at the moment. We need to get another one of those buildings unlocked, and we actually will be getting one soon with the alchemy. I don't know if it's the alchemy school or alchemy lab, but one of those. It's the alchemy lab, so that'll turn the gold into analytics. So give us another use for this gold that we're working on getting. Alright, so I suppose that is the end of today's episode. We're exploring the world, starting to uncover things. We found the new continent, met Egypt. And just moving through the Age of Alchemy, about halfway through, almost. We gotta get 2 texts here now. Or excuse me, we gotta get 4 texts, and we almost have 2. And I don't know if we'll go back and get anything else until it goes back to one turn. When it's just one turn per tech, we'll knock these out. Gunpowder would be okay to get, so we can get the cannons. That'll be helpful for taking cities. But yeah, other than that, I just don't see going back getting any of these at the moment. We'll just be working on these stacks. So we'll get 2 more here. But I don't know if we want to rush to the Age of Revolution, because that has that conflict. You start seeing the revolutions break out everywhere. And so do we really want to rush to that age when we're busy doing other things at the moment? So I don't know. We'll see how long it takes us to get there. I hope you guys did enjoy today's episode. If you did, make sure you leave a like on the video, subscribe to our channel, hit that notification bell, and leave a comment. We hope to see you on the next one. And thanks for watching.